when you think about this as a human issue, as a humanitarian issue, you know, a lot of times everybody wants a sustainable solution to this and a sustainable, you know, the use of that kind of the word sustainability. And I think, you know, that's where you have to kind of look at sustainability, but you also have to look at what it is to be humanitarian. And when you look at a crisis of this sort, and frankly, it's expensive work. This isn't, I'm sure, you know, organizations in the US like Homeboy and organizations here, we work in this. This is a lot of work because it does take, when you think about trauma and healing, and I think there's a World Health Organization statistic that if you've survived violence, you're 5.5 times more likely to perpetrate, right? And this is anybody. And then there's also the risk of victimization, of re-victimization. So, you know, if you really look at the science, when you perpetrate, you've probably survived, you've been a victim, you've survived some sort of violence yourself. And understanding that and understanding the importance of that healing. And I think that requires the community-based approaches, right? So it requires, you know, working in schools, working with children when they're little, and not saying I'm going to work I don't think constantly also saying, you know, this is a gang affected community. We're working with young people. We're working with communities that face, you know, much fewer access to opportunities. Yeah. Do they have family members or are they in gangs? For us, it's like, look, people deserve opportunities. And I think when you're in these communities, at least the kids we talk to, they're tired of just being categorized, whether they're a community with or without gangs. It's not, you know, it's not about that. It's about young people. It's about their parents. It's about their families. And I think the community-based approaches, and I was taking some notes here too, because I think it's also about making sure that public schools, public hospitals, when someone arrives in a hospital with a violent injury and they look a certain way, whether they have tattoos or they look a certain way, that the healthcare personnel are going to continue to, they say in Spanish, violentar, like if you continue to stigmatize and to mistreat people because of your perception of what someone looks like that is just a bad person or a dangerous or violent person, you're perpetuating this constant aggression. And I think anybody who's in a situation that's survived violent injury, if you're able to work with institutions, work with healthcare providers, work with frontline workers, first responders, healthcare providers, teachers, to understand what it means to be trauma-informed, I think you can start building the institutional capabilities that you need, because you can't just have one intervention. You can't just work in reintegration. You can't just work in the prisons. And I think we work with, here in El Salvador, with the Centro de Inserción Social Femenino, which is the only girls juvenile detention center, essentially. And for us, it's like, we want to understand, like, what, how do you end up here, right? Like, really kind of gather that experience and understand, how do you end up here and what conditions need to be met for you to not end up here? Because, by the way, perpetuating violence is as traumatic as surviving violence. Like, the impact on your brain and on your body is just as bad. Nobody enjoys inflicting pain on other people. Maybe like a minuscule proportion of, you know, sociopaths. But anyway, I think it's just understanding this restorative vision, because law enforcement and punitive measures, we've seen, like Roberto said over and over again, it doesn't work. And looking at the science, does cognitive behavioral therapy work? Does mindfulness work? What works? Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. But what we do know is communities are key to healing. And so if they have the knowledge, which they already have the wisdom, but if they have the science and the knowledge, it's a different approach. It's a more constructive and purposeful approach.